To my YouTube channel MK Mediguide lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy. In this video, we will discuss about the neuroglia. Well, neurostains are nervous system, while glia is a Greek word that means glue. These cells are named neuroglia because the early histologists were believing neuroglial cells that they are the glue that held the nervous tissues together. And that's why neuroglial cells are also named glial cells. Neuroglial cells are sometimes called non-neural cells, because these cells are non-excitable and do not transmit nerve impulses like neurons. Neuroglia or glial cells are the supporting cells of the nervous system. Compared to neurons, glial cells are 5 to 15 times greater in numbers than neurons in the nervous system, because these cells can divide, whereas neurons do not normally divide. Neurons cannot exist without neuroglia, which build spaces, provide structural frameworks, produce myelin, and carry on phagocytosis. Neuroglial cells are classified into the central neuroglial cells and the peripheral neuroglial cells based on their presence in the CNS and peripheral nervous system. The central neuroglial cells are of four types. These are microglial cells, oligodendrocytes, astrocytes, and ependymal cells. While, on the other hand, the peripheral neuroglial cells are classified as Schwann cells and satellite cells. For more detail about these cells, here I'm drawing neurons in a blood capillary representative of a section of the CNS, for example. And here it is a microglial cell, right? Microglial cells, as the name indicates, that is, the micro means small. So these cells are the smallest glial cells that are scattered throughout the central nervous system. They are also called the macrophages of the CNS because they phagocytize bacterial cells and cellular debris. And secondly, like macrophages, they are also derived from monocytes that migrate from the blood into the nervous system before birth. After this, we have the oligodendrocytes. Oligodendrocytes align along axons and have only a few processes. They produce insulating layers of myelin that is a lipid protein substance called a myelin sheath around the axons within the brain and spinal cord. The third type of neuroglial cells we have in the central nervous system are the astrocytes. Astrocytes or star-shaped cells, commonly found between neurons and blood vessels, and have a special role in the formation of the blood-brain barrier, which helps to regulate the concentrations of nutrients and ions within the tissue. These cells provide structural support to the neurons and extend their processes to cover the synapses within the central nervous system, and with this following injury form scar tissue. The last type of central nervous system neuroglia is the ependymal cells. Ependymal cells form an epithelial-like membrane that encloses ventricles in the brain and central canal of the spinal cord. These enclosed spaces have cerebrospinal fluid, which protects and nourishes the brain and spinal cord. They also form the blood-cerebrospinal fluid barrier. So, it was all about the central nervous system neuroglial cells. Now, let's move to the peripheral neuroglial cells, which are found in the peripheral nervous system, as the name indicates. Here, for example, this is a peripheral neuron here, okay? In the peripheral nervous system, we have Schwann cells and satellite cells. Schwann cells wrap around the axons of neurons. Schwann cells are also known as neurolymphocytes. Like oligodendrocytes, they form the myelin sheath around axons, but in the peripheral nervous system, while the oligodendrocytes myelinate axons in the CNS. Furthermore, a single oligodendrocyte myelinates several axons, but each one cell myelinates a single axon, as I have shown here. The myelin sheath helps in the conduction of nerve impulses and promotes regeneration of a damaged neuron in the peripheral nervous system. Lastly, we have the satellite cells. Well, satellite cells are the peripheral glial cells that are sometimes known as the ganglionic gliocytes. Satellite cells are small, flattened cells that mainly support the ganglia within the peripheral nervous system. And with this, thanks for watching. Do like and share this video and subscribe to our channel for more videos.